lot of the most interesting evolution has happened in the oceans. The vast majority of the diversity in the world is still in the oceans, and it all began in the oceans. And the organisms we study, corals, are some of the most distantly related organisms to humans. And so you can gain a lot of insight into evolution by studying these groups that are really distantly related to us, and they're all in the ocean. So I'm Ryan McMines, and I'm a PhD student at Oregon State University. And I'm in the Department of Microbiology, and we study coral microbiology and the ecology of microbes in the ocean. I kind of chose Lizard Island of all the different places I could go in the Great Barrier Reef in Australia, because we have a list of all the different coral groups that we're looking for, and Lizard Island, of all the places in the world we were hoping to go to, had the largest number of those groups.
Well, Lizard Island is a fantastic spot on the Great Barrier Reef, and we provide facilities for researchers to conduct the work that they need to do. So there's accommodation, there's boats, laboratories, aquarium facilities, all the stuff that they need to do whatever it is that they want to do on the reef. We really pride ourselves on having a really flexible facility so that we can do all sorts of different projects. And we do many different projects. There's about 100 different ones done here every year. And we get about 100 different publications from those projects every year.
I've pretty much enjoyed all the different research stations I've been to. But this is definitely like the most organized and most set up research station I've been to. So I get up, I've got a couple of things to prepare in the lab to get myself ready for collections. I'm collecting mucus, and I use a little syringe to collect that mucus while I'm underwater. And then I'm taking a small fragment of the coral, and so I need a sterile bag to put that in. I prepare all those, pre-label everything, because I can't really write on these things underwater. Then I'll go down to the dive shed and make sure all my scuba equipment is together, put it all in the bins and everything. We'll load up the boat, and we'll go out to the reef.
Once you just head into the water, it's a completely different world. Gravity doesn't affect you as much, and fish are completely different. Just the environment and those reefs, those corals are just amazingly beautiful. There's just so many different species and so many different colors, and there's a lot that we don't know about them because it's so hard to do science down there. Everything is so different. You have waves, you have wind, you have depth.
While I'm on the dive, I start with a kind of 15-minute, 20-minute survey of the reef, just kind of looking for what I'm going to sample. And then I'll sample the mucus and take pictures of all these colonies, make sure it's documented, take a small fragment and collect that and put it in the bag. And then we come back to the boat, put it on ice, motor back to the shore. And so I get to the shore and immediately try to start processing these samples that I've taken. At the end of a day, I feel successful if I identified my species correctly and I got some new groups that I've been looking for. The very tangible results that we're hoping to find or assist other groups in finding later are the basic biology of how corals interact with the microbes in the environment. In the end, that can shed light on why we're losing corals, which is a big problem right now.
I've been coming here for 30 years odd, and I can certainly see differences in the reef. Coral cover is down by about 50% from 25 years ago, which is pretty sad to see. That's not to say that the reefs are sad to look at now. They're not. They look beautiful. but it's not as amazing as it was 30 years ago, that's for sure.
If you remove the corals, there's not going to be any fish either. They use corals for shelter, so they can hide from predators. They also use it for reproduction, but also a lot of those species actually feed on corals. So that's very worrying because it's one of the most diverse and most beautiful ecosystem that we have on the planet.
We're really losing coral reefs fast due to various problems like runoff, climate change, you know, ocean acidification, et cetera. In a lot of cases, we know why the corals are dying, but in a lot of other cases, we don't. And so we want to be able to understand those processes better. And if we understand them better, we might be able to figure out ways to stop from losing them.